got this Radcliffe here in the show.
Yes.
Love Radcliffe's work. You know, he had a fantastic show at the High Museum.
A couple years ago. Yes. His current work is fabulous as well.
So is that why I'm showing at the Loveless Museum?
You're showing at the Loveless Museum because you're a fabulous artist too.
Oh, wow.
But we were really lucky to get one of his early pieces. This is from the late 90s, and this was the first work I ever saw of his. I saw it actually first at the Albany Museum of Art from this series.
Okay.
And that museum have also an African, they have an African collection. So they have ritualistic figures where the medicine is put into the belly of the figures. And that's what he's going for in this series, with this kind of window with objects on the inside. And he was another artist who uses found photographs, just like Whitfield LaBelle. So we have that in the middle. And also an African-American spiritual written there in the middle. And then all these great symbols all around. I didn't know before I saw the series that these are kind of the tie rods to the end of a brick building. You know, we have to put rods through, and there's a decorative element that can be stars or circles. This is a symbol that comes from an Inca cloth in West Africa. And African-American slaves who were now being iron workers and metal workers in America kind of incorporated that symbol into it. So that's why this is here.
Interesting. You know, I guess, you know, the things that, of course, I appreciate his use of the found photography, which oftentimes is a lot of his family members, who I understand correctly.
Right.
And this whole nature here gives a good feel of an altar space. But the tactile nature of the work, you know, is textual, you know, it's painterly, and yet handles this whole abstraction well. So
it's particularly painterly with the drips coming down. It's almost like abstract expressionism. It's gorgeous.
No, absolutely. Another fantastic piece here at the Columbus Museum.
Yes.